We had a very interesting 1.5 hour of discussion. I'd quickly like to take this opportunity to quickly run through what were the key points we spoke of. In terms of key issues which the group felt were one of the most important things the group echoed was there is a phenomenal amount of lack of awareness in terms of where a talent lies and where can the industry patrons go to hire. Can there be, and the subsequent thought that came, that can there be, which somebody alluded to earlier, can there be a portal where the entire talent database could be aggregated? And in India, we can see that if you filter on a certain skill, this is the kind of talent that is available. So that awareness and visibility of availability became a very important moot point of discussion, which one of the key issues impacting. The other is, which industry patrons have, the lack of standardization. There is a phenomenal amount of difference between a tier A, a tier B, or a tier C college pass outs. Now, can there be curriculum standardized? Can there be education delivery standardized that ensures that the quality of the education and therefore the students we hire from are similar, and therefore the in companies don't have to really go through all the details, so on and so forth. Some of the other critical key issues that got discussed, therefore, were also sometimes in terms of lack of synchronization between the central, the state government, or for that matter, the skill council, and so on and so forth. Is there one authority to speak to? Is there one authority to talk to, with whom all the actions could be discussed and deliberated? I think these are the, I won't really go through all the aspect, but one very important aspect which came from the gentleman from Godrej & Boyce was, which is not to do with the government, but more to do with the social aspect. Can we encourage dignity of labor through our communication, through our engagement? Because there's so much amount of demand of a certain kind of workforce in the industry, but there are no takers for those jobs simply because those jobs are not felt to be extremely respected or reputed. Those are some of the key issues we spoke of. The role of the industry in trying to solve these problems, of course, industry academia partnerships became extremely important. We do have pockets of excellence where industry and academia participate, but can there be more commitment from the industry in terms of putting across content for colleges to train on, training the faculties to colleges to train on, and also a commitment for intake from the colleges? Because if there is training and there is no intake, the partnership doesn't really work. Government industry partnership, again, the group felt that forums like these of interaction of partnership should be encouraged, whereby ideas could be exchanged and deliberated. Channelizing CSR funds for skilling, there are mandates in CSR fund, but can the organization be free to use them for reskilling also in terms of a greater proportion to what they currently do? And priority of employment to skill certified people, I think accreditation and certification also became an important point that could be touched on. Areas of collaboration, very similar, the spreading of the apprenticeship program, industry support for training the trainers, and government industry partnership is something that I've just mentioned. Support needed, can the government prepare a repository of skills and make it available on a portal for every user to look at? Can we add, I don't know if it's premature, but to the skill development, or for that matter, any other college curriculum, formal entrepreneurship programs that ensure that we just don't look for jobs, we also create jobs ourselves. And some of the training colleagues who had voiced out the concerns about the funding and the delays in the funds to be reaching them from the government. I think those were the key things that we spoke of. If I've missed on any of the points, participants from Group 4 can please elaborate and add on. And thank you so much. We had a great discussion. Thank you for the opportunity.